Dear students, in order to simplify the calculation of moment of inertia of various rigid bodies, we can have two general theorems related with moment of inertia. The theorems are called, one is the parallel axis theorem and the next one is the perpendicular axis theorem. We can go through these theorems. So, what is the parallel axis theorem? So, you can see there is a rigid body. And we have to find out the moment of inertia of this rigid body about this axis. So you can say about the axis AB. Okay. So we know the moment of inertia of this rigid body about an axis that is passing through the center of mass. That is, you can see in the blue color there is an axis. What is the particularity of that axis? That is, the axis is passing through the center of gravity, and we know the moment of inertia of this rigid body, the center of about an axis passing through the center of gravity. Okay, then according to the parallel axis theorem, if we know the moment of inertia of a given body about an axis passing through the center of gravity, then we can find the moment of inertia about any parallel axis. We can find the moment of inertia about any parallel axis. Okay, parallel axis to the axis passing the moment of the center of mass. Okay, so the parallel axis theorem gives a simple relation to find the moment of inertia about any parallel axis AB, provided we should know the moment of inertia about the parallel axis passing through the center of mass. Okay, so in the figure, suppose IG is the moment of inertia about the parallel axis passing through the center of mass, then the moment of inertia of the body about any parallel axis, suppose here we have an axis AB, about any parallel axis is given as I is equal to IG plus capital M A square. Okay, IG, you know, that is the moment of inertia about a parallel axis passing through the center of mass. And what is capital M? Capital M is the total mass of the body, and A is the distance between the two parallel axes. Okay, so that is the parallel axis theorem. So let's have a statement. The moment of inertia I of any rigid body about a given axis is equal to the sum of the sum of its moment of inertia IG about a parallel axis passing through the center of mass. And what is the second term? That is the product of the mass of the body and the square of the distance between the axes. Okay, so that is the parallel axis theorem. Now we are moving to the perpendicular axis theorem. Okay. The perpendicular axis theorem help us to calculate the moment of inertia of the plane lamina. So you can see a rigid body in the form of a plane lamina. Okay. And you can have the three axes. And the two axes OX and OY are lie in the plane of the lamina. right, in the plane of the lamina. And the third axis, OZ, is perpendicular to the plane of the lamina. Okay. So that is the situation. We have a plane lamina that is in the form of a disc, or in the form of a mobile, or in the form of a laptop, or in the form of a book. Okay, all these are the examples for the plane lamina. Okay, so in the case of plane lamina, so what the perpendicular axis theorem says? Let's have the statement. The sum of the moment of inertia of a plane lamina about the two mutually perpendicular axes lying its plane is equal to the moment of inertia about an axis perpendicular to the plane of the lamina and passing through the point of intersection of the first two axes. So let us repeat. The sum of the moment of inertia of a plane lamina about two mutually perpendicular axes lying its plane is equal to the moment of inertia about an axis perpendicular to the plane of the lamina, perpendicular to the plane of the lamina, and passing through the point of intersection of the first two axes. Okay. Here we have the two axes, that is OX and OY. That are the two mutually perpendicular axes. Okay, that two axes are lying in the plane lamina. Okay, if that is situation, then what is the perpendicular axis theorem says? The sum of the moment of inertia of the plane lamina above the two axes, above the two, these two perpendicular axes, that is about OX and OY. Okay, that is equal to, that is equal to the moment of inertia of this plane lamina about this perpendicular axis. This axis, that is also this perpendicular to the plane lamina, that is perpendicular to both OX and OY. Okay, and also this OZ should pass through the point of intersection, that is O. It should pass through the point of intersection of the first two axes. Okay. If it is a situation, then we can express the sum of the moment of inertia, that is about the two perpendicular axes in the plane of lamina, that is Ix and Iy, mirai Ix and Iy. Okay, so that is equal to the moment of inertia of the plane lamina about a mutually perpendicular axis. Okay. That is perpendicular to the plane lamina and passing through the point of intersection, that is Iz. Suppose that Iz is the moment of inertia about the OZ, then we can express Iz is equal to Ix plus Iy. Iz is equal to Ix plus Iy. So that is the perpendicular axis theorem. Okay. So next we are going to find the moment of inertia of the sum of the common rigid bodies. Okay, so let us see how these theorems help us to find out the moment of inertia. Okay, first we are going to find the moment of inertia of a ring about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane. Okay, for a ring, you can see. You can use your the ring that you can use in your finger, or you can also consider the same a bangle as a ring in the case of so for that are for some of the examples. Okay, so we are going to find out the moment of inertia of the ring about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its plane. Okay. So suppose we have a ring. So you can see in the O is the center, and we are going to find the moment of inertia of this ring about an axis passing through the center, is passing through O and perpendicular to its plane. That means the axis, which is when you are looking into the mobile, you can see the axis is passing through O and perpendicular to the plane. That means that is here the axis is passing through the mobile. Okay. That is towards you or inwards or upwards you. Okay, so that is the axis. This we are going to find the moment of inertia about that axis. Okay. So for that, here the mass of the ring is capital M, and capital R is the radius. Capital R is the radius. Okay. So to find the moment of inertia of this ring, we are going to find the moment of inertia of a very small length element. For that purpose, we dividing the ring into very small elements. Okay, very small element. Here let us consider a very small element of mass small m. Okay, now the moment of inertia of this small element about an axis passing through this center and perpendicular to the plane, that is the perpendicular to the mobile, okay, or the laptop, or the okay. So what is the moment of inertia of a particle? We are already saying what is the moment of inertia of a single particle about an axis of rotation, that is m into r square. Okay, here what is the moment of inertia of this small element passing through the center and perpendicular to this plane of the ring? That is equal to the mass into the radius square, that is m into r square. Okay, so the moment of inertia of the entire ring that we can obtain by taking the summation of the moment of inertia of such a small elements. Now we are already divided the ring into very small elements, and we consider one such element, and we have the moment of inertia of that small element mr square. Okay, so to find the moment of inertia of the entire ring is obtained by adding the moment of inertia or taking the summation of the moment of inertia of these small elements. So the moment of inertia of the complete ring is equal to taking the summation that is sigma m small m r square. Okay, so you can see the distance r here, that means here the radius r is the same for all elementary masses. Okay, then we can take the r from the, we can take an outside the r from the summation, that is r square sigma m. So what is sigma m? M is the element, mass of the small element. So what is sigma m? Sigma m is the mass of the sum of the masses of the small elements. So that is the total mass of the ring. That is the total mass of the ring. Then the moment of inertia of the ring is equal to m r square. It is equal to m r square. Okay. So that is the moment of inertia of the ring about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane. That is I is equal to m r square. Now we are going to find the moment of inertia of the ring about a given diameter. Okay. Now we have the ring and we have the two axes, that is y dash and x dash. Both are lie along the diameters. Okay. So both two axes are nothing but that are the diameters. So in order to find the moment of inertia of the ring about this diameter, about any diameter, we are going to use the perpendicular axis theorem. Okay. So we already have the moment of inertia of the ring about a perpendicular axis passing through the center, that is perpendicular to the mobile screen or the mobile. Okay. So that we know, that moment of inertia, what is the expression? That is mr square. Okay, that is the mr square. Okay, here the moment of inertia about xx dash and the moment of inertia about yy dash are the same, because these two axes are the diameters. So the diameters are the same. As you know, diameters are the same. So moment of inertia about these two diameters are the same. So we can find only the moment of inertia about any diameter. Okay. Suppose I is the moment of inertia about any diameter. Suppose here these are the two diameters. I is the moment of inertia. Here also that is the same. That is I is the moment of inertia. Okay. So we are going to find the moment of inertia about this diameter by using the perpendicular axis theorem. Okay. Over here we have the two axes that lying in the plane of the ring. So both are the mutually perpendicular. And these two axes are meeting at the center of the the ring. Okay, so by applying the moment of inertia, by applying the perpendicular axis theorem, we have I z is equal to ix plus iy. Okay, here I z, ix and iy, that both are the same. Okay. That is equal to I plus I. Okay, that is 2I is equal to, what is IZ? IZ is the moment of inertia of the ring about the perpendicular axis passing through the center, that is passing through the O. That already we have already derived that expression. Okay. That is m r square. That is m r square. Okay. Therefore, the moment of inertia I is equal to m r square by 2. I is equal to m r square by 2. That is the moment of inertia of the ring about a diameter. Okay. Now, the moment of inertia of the ring about a tangent. Okay, so in the figure you can see there is a ring that is we have the two diameters, that yy dash and xx dash. Okay, and there is a tangent. The tangent AB is drawn at the end of a ring, at the edge of a ring. Okay, let I be the moment of inertia of the ring about the tangent. We have to find the I is the moment of inertia of the ring about the tangent that we are going to find out. Okay. So here we have an axis yy dash. What is the particularity of this yy dash? The yy dash axis, that is this diameter, is parallel to yy is parallel to the tangent, and also this axis or the diameter is passing through the center of mass of the ring. Okay, so that we are going to use the parallel axis theorem. So this we can take the moment of inertia about this axis is the, that is the moment of inertia of the ring about an axis passing through the the centromeres. Okay, so more definition about this yy dash of this diameter that we know. The value of ig is we know, we are already derived. That is I is equal to mr square, ig is equal to mr square by 2. That we already we know. Okay, so by using the parallelogram theorem, we can find the moment of inertia about the tangent. Okay, so what is the parallelogram theorem? Parallelogram theorem, I is equal to ig plus m a square. Ig plus m a square. Here, what is I? I is the moment of inertia about the tangent AB. And what is ig? Ig is the moment of inertia of the ring. That is the parallel axis, and which is passing through the center of mass. For in the case of a ring, the center of mass is placed at the center of the ring. Okay, so this axis, that is this diameter, yy dash, diameter is passing through that center of mass. So the moment of inertia about this, that is about yy dash, that is the diameter, we already have its value. That is ig, we know. So, and m is the total mass of the ring, and a is the distance between two parallel axes. Here, what is that? The distance between the two parallel axes, that is the radius, okay? Yy dash and ab, the distance between yy dash and ab, that is nothing but that is the radius of the ring, okay? So, I is equal to ig, we know we already derived that expression, that is mr square by 2 plus here m is the total mass and the distance between the two axes is r square r, so that is r square. So what is the expression? That is equal to 3 by 2 mr square, 3 by 2 mr square. Okay, so that is the moment of inertia of the ring about a tangent that we can find with the help of the parallel axis theorem. Okay. Next, we are going to find the moment of inertia of a circular disk about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane. So, what is a disk? For example, you can have the disk means puppet is an example for the shape. It's a disk. For a good example is the lid of a vehicle. For example, the lid of a vessel. Okay, that we are using in the kitchen, and the lid is an example for a. That is a very common example. Okay, so we have a disk, and we are going to find the moment of inertia of the disk about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane. So for the disk, there is a uniform distribution of mass. There is a uniform distribution of mass through the entire surface. So in the case of a ring, the mass lies along the circumference of that ring. There is no mass is distributed inside the ring. Okay, but in the case of a circular disk, the total mass is distributed the entire the surface. Okay, so we let us consider such a circular disk of capital M and radius capital R. Now, to find the moment of inertia of this disk, we are going to assume that this disk is made up of a large number of rings of very small width and of gradually increasing radii from 0 to capital R. Okay, capital R is the radius of the circular disk. So, we are going to consider this three, this circular disk is split above, we can consider this made up of a large number of the circular disk, like this. So it's a large number of the annular rings, okay, of the very small width and its radii. The radius of the each ring is increasing from the center to the outer part of the disk. That is, its radius is increasing from 0 to capital R. Okay, so we assume that the disk is made up of a large number of this kind of annular rings. So we are going to consider such a ring of radius x and the width is dx. Okay. So we assume that the disk is made up of a large number of annular rings whose radius is increasing from 0 to capital R. Okay. So in order to calculate the moment of inertia of the disk, we first calculate the moment of inertia of this annular ring and we make the summation. Okay. So that is the procedure we are going to adopt here. So first we are going to find this moment of inertia of this annular ring. Okay. Now if m is the total mass of the disk and r is the radius of the disk, then what is the mass per unit area of the disk? What is the mass per unit area of the disk? What is the area of the disk, entire disk? That is pi r square. So what is the mass per unit area of the disk? That is m divided by pi r square. M divided by pi r square. Now coming to the annular ring. What is the area of the annular ring? What is the area of the annular ring? Okay. What is the area here? The annular ring has the thickness or the width is dx and the radius is x. So what is the area of the annular ring? The area of the annular ring is equal to the circumference into the width of the ring, that is 2 pi x into dx. Okay, so that is the area of the annular ring. Okay, now we have the area of the annular ring. We already have the mass per unit area. Okay, so for the annular ring, the area is here. So what is the mass of the annular ring? The mass of the annular ring we know the mass per unit area. So for the unit area, the mass is this. So for the annular ring, the area is 2 pi x into dx. So the mass of the annular ring is equal to the mass per unit area and the area of the annular ring. That is 2 pi x into dx. Okay. So you can cancel out pi and pi, and okay. So 2x dx m by r square. Okay. Now what is the moment of inertia of this ring? So we have now we have the mass of the annular ring, okay, and also we have the radius of the annular ring, that is x. Okay, now what is the moment of inertia of this ring about an axis passing through its center and a perpendicular display, that is the axis which is directed towards you. Okay, that is perpendicular to the surface of the movie. Okay, so what is that moment of inertia? What is the expression for the moment of inertia? We already derived that expression, that is m r square. Okay, in the case of a ring, the moment of inertia about the perpendicular axis is m r square. Okay, here we have the annular ring. The mass of the annular ring is 2x dx into m r square. And what is the radius of this annular ring? That is the x. So mass into radius square, that is 2x dx m by r square into, that is, this is the mass into radius. Here what is the radius? That is x, that is x square. Okay, so the moment of inertia of a ring I can express 2 m by r square into x cube dx into x cube dx. Okay, about this is the moment of inertia of the ring about the perpendicular axis. Okay, now since the disk is made up of large number of this kind of annular ring, we have to make the to find the moment of inertia of the entire disk is obtained by making the summation of this moment of inertia of the individual rings. Since here the distribution of mass is uniform, instead of we are making the summation, here we are making a mathematical technique called integration. It's called integration. Okay. Here we are integrating. There is a mathematical, instead of making the summation, since the distribution of mass is uniform, the distribution is continuous. The distribution of mass is continuous. We are using the mathematical technique called integration. Okay. So the moment of inertia of the entire disk can be obtained by integrating the moment of inertia of the annular ring between the limits x equal to 0 to x equal to 6. Here the annular ring, the disk is made up of a large number of annular rings and with the radii from the center to the outer part of the ring. That is, the radii is increasing from x equal to 0 to x equal to 6. That we are taking the limits of our integration. Okay, so let us move to this mathematical part. That is, so the I is equal to the moment of inertia of the entire disk. I is equal to integral the limits x equal to 0 to x equal to r, the moment of inertia of the annular ring, that is 2m by r square x cube dx. Okay, so here the integration is with respect to x. We are taking the other terms outside the integration part, that is 2m by r square, that we can take it outside, and the integration is for only x. Here x is the variable, the x is increasing from 0 to capital R. Okay, so when we take about there is a standard result for the this kind of integral, that is integral x raised to n dx. If the function is like this, then integral is obtained by the result is x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Okay, that we can apply here. Then 2m divided by r square. So we apply that result. X raised to 4 divided by 4. And we have to apply the limit here, that is x equal to 0. Then x equal to r. Okay. Next, we are going to apply the limits. Here the 4 is a constant, that is also we can take it outside. That is 2m divided by 4 r square. And we are going to apply the limits that we are applying the above. You are substituting the upper limit first minus the lower limit. That is, instead of x, we can apply the first we can apply the upper limit. That is r x equal to r. That is r raised to 4 minus. Then we apply the lower limit in the place of x. That is here the lower limit is 0. That is 0 raised to 4. That is 0. Okay. That is equal to. Next, as here we can cancel the 2. Okay. So that is m divided by m r raised to 4 divided by 2 r square. That is also we can take it. We can make the we can cancel the r raised to 4 and r square. That is the r square by 2 r square by 2. So the moment of inertia of the disk about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its plane is given by mr square by 2. Okay. So that is the moment of inertia of the disk. Now we are going to find the moment of inertia, as we have seen in the case of a ring, and the moment of inertia of the disk about a given diameter. Here we can use the which theorem? Here we can use the perpendicular axis theorem. Okay. Here we have a disk and we have the two diameters AB and CD. Both are perpendicular and passing through the center O. Okay. So we already know the moment of inertia of this disk about a perpendicular axis, that is towards you. The axis is towards you, perpendicular to the mobile. That we know, that we have derived that expression. So the moment of inertia of the disk about a diameter, here these two diameters AB and CD are the diameters, and the moment of inertia when we calculate the moment of inertia, that is the same, because these two axes are the diameters, and the disk is symmetrical about these the diameters. So the moment of inertia are also the same. Okay. So let us put the moment of inertia about the diameters as I. So I and I. So instead of Ix and Iy, here we can take the both are the I. Okay. So when we apply the moment of inertia, when we apply the perpendicular axis theorem, Iz is equal to Ix plus Iy. Ix plus Iy. Here both the diameters are the same, so we can have I plus I. We can have I plus I. So what is that I plus I? Here that is Iz. Okay. So what is Iz? Iz we are already derived. That is what is Iz? Iz is equal to mr square by 2. The Iz is the moment of inertia of this disk about the perpendicular axis and passing through the center. Okay. Here we have that value. That expression is mr square by 2. That is 2i is equal to m r square by 2. Therefore, I is equal to what is M R square by 4. Okay, so that is the Mohr definition of the disk about a diameter. About a diameter. Okay, that we are using with the help of, we are finding with the help of the perpendicular axis theorem. Okay. Now similarly, we can also find the Mohr definition of the disk about a tangent with the help of the parallel axis theorem. Okay, here we have a disk and AB is the diameter which is passing through the center. Here in the case of a circular disk, the center point is the center of mass of the disk. Okay, so let's draw a tangent, the tangent PQ that is along the edge. So this tangent is parallel to this diameter AB. So we can find this moment of inertia about this tangent, about this axis, by the help of the parallel axis theorem. So parallel axis theorem I is equal to IG plus M A square. Okay, here these two axes are parallel, and also the AB is the diameter which is passing through the center of mass. So the moment of inertia about AB, that is the moment of inertia of the axis passing through the center of mass. Okay, that is IG. That we know expression, that is the moment of inertia about this diameter, that is the axis which is passing through the center of mass, that is mr square by 4. Okay, and so we can apply parallel axis theorem. Here IG is equal to mr square by 4 plus, here m is capital M is the total mass of the disk, that is capital M. A here, what is A? A is the distance between the two axes. Okay, what is that? The distance between the two axes, that is the radius. Okay, so here R is the A, so R square. Okay, so you can make the summation, and you can add these two values, that is 5 by 4 m r square, 5 by 4 m r square. Okay, so that is the moment of inertia of the disk about a tangent, which we have derived with the help of the parallel axis theorem. Okay, so the procedure is same as the ring. Okay, in the case of a ring, we have find the moment of inertia of the ring about the diameter with the help of the perpendicular axis theorem. In the case of a disk also, we are using the perpendicular axis theorem, and the moment of inertia of the disk about a tangent, we are using the parallel axis theorem. In the case of the ring, we are also using the parallel axis theorem. So the procedures are the same, but the final expressions are different, because one is the ring and another is the disk. Okay, so in the similar way, we can find the moment of inertia of any shape of rigid body. Okay.